Welcome class. Here we are going to start exercise 9.3 infinite series. So what is meant by infinite series? An infinite series is an expression in the form summation k varying from 1 to infinity a k. This is a symbol for summation, that is we are adding the terms by varying k from 1 to infinity. So putting k is equal to 1 a 1, for k is equal to 2 we get a 2, and so on. The general term is a k and so on. So this summation is representing we are adding all the terms. So such expression is named as infinite series. You can see that we are just adding the terms of a sequence. So in simple words, you can see that infinite series means we are adding the terms of an infinite sequence. We all know that sequence is always infinite. So by adding the terms of a sequence, we get an infinite series. So here this is here we have an example. We are having a geometric sequence right now: 3 by 10, 3 by 10 square, 3 by 10 cube, and so on. And just by adding the terms, we get an infinite series in this form. Now we will discuss about the convergence of infinite series, or the summation, or the sum of the infinite series. We have recently discussed the convergence of sequence. So now we are going to discuss the convergence of series. So let us suppose that Sn denote the sum of initial terms of the series up to and including the term with index n, that is S1 is basically the first term, S2 is basically the sum of first two terms, that is A1 plus A2 or U1 plus U2. S3 is the sum of first three terms, that is U1 plus U2 plus U3, and so on. Similarly, Sn will be the sum of first n terms, that is U1 plus U2 plus U3 plus up to so on UN. So here we are representing the partial sums. These are named as partial sums basically. So the number Sn is called the nth partial sum of the series, and the sequence, you can see we are having a sequence of partial sums of the series. And the if such sequence of partial sums is convergent, then we will say that our series is convergent, otherwise it will be divergent. We have discussed about the convergence of sequences, that we have to take the limit and approaches to infinity on the general term of the sequence, and if we get a constant real number, then we will say that it is convergent, otherwise it will be divergent. So we will apply the same rule on sequence of partial sums as well. So this is how we can discuss the convergence of infinite series, that if the sequence of partial sums is convergent, then our series will be convergent, otherwise it will be divergent. For example, here we have question number 8 from the exercise. We are given with a series and we have to check that if the series is convergent or divergent. So the series is given to us is summation k varying from 1 to infinity 1 over 2 power k minus 1 over 2 power k plus 1. So obviously we are going to discuss about the sequence of partial sums. If that sequence is convergent, then our series will be convergent. So S1 is equal to the first term, so putting k is equal to 1, we get 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4. Now for S2 is basically the sum of first two terms, that is A1 plus A2, or we have to put k is equal to 1 and k is equal to 2, and then we will add the two terms. So by putting k is equal to 1, we get this term 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4, and by putting k is equal to 2, we get the term 1 by 4 minus 1 by 8. So by solving this, 1 by 4 and 1 by 4 will be cancelled out, and we are left with 1 by 2 minus 1 by 8. Now for S3 is the sum of first three terms, so putting k is equal to 1, k is equal to 2, and k is equal to 3. And on simplifying, you can see that this 1 by 4 will be cancelled out, 1 by 8 will be cancelled out, and we are left with 1 by 2 minus 1 by 16. So here we are having the first three terms of the sequence of partial sums, and now we will try to generalize this sequence. And this is clear that we are going to have 1 by 2 is being constant, is remains the same. So 1 by 2 minus, now for S1 we get 1 by 4, that is 1 by 2 square. For S is equal to 2, we get 1 by 8 over here, that is 2 raised to the power 2 plus 1. And for S3, we get 1 by 2 minus 1 by 16, that is 1 by 2 raised to the power 4 or 3 plus 1. So we are going to generalize it in the term 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 raised to the power n plus 1. Now we will apply the limit on this general term, limit and approaches to infinity Sn, which is going to be 1 by 2 minus 1 by 2 power n plus 1, and clearly it is going to be 1 by 2, that is our series is convergent in this case and its sum is equal to 1 by 2. there are different types of series, and right now we are having a geometric series. And in geometric series, each term is obtained by multiplying the preceding term by some fixed constant. That fixed constant is normally represented by R, and it is named as the common ratio. And the first term is represented by A. So here you can see that we will multiply the first term with R to get the second term, that is AR. Then we will multiply the second term with R to get the third term, that is AR square. Then we will multiply it with R to get the next term, which is going to be AR cube, and so on. So we can generalize it in the form summation k varying from 0 to infinity AR raised to the power k. Such series are called the geometric series. Here are some examples as well. 1 plus 2 plus 4 plus 8, obviously this is 2 power k, that is A will be 1 and R is equal to 2 in this case. Then we get 3 by 10, 3 by 10 square, 3 by 10 cube, and so on. So in this case, this is also a geometric series with the first term 3 by 10, and in this case R will be 1 by 10. Because only the powers of 10 are changing in the denominator. Then the second one is 1 by 2 minus 1 by 4 plus 1 by 8 minus 1 by 16. It means we are changing the sign. That is, we have to put minus 1 raised to the power some number. So here you can see the first term is positive. That is, we have to make it even. So minus 1 raised to the power k plus 1, 1 over 2 power k. And in this case, A is equal to 1 by 2 and R is equal to minus 1 by 2 because it is changing its sign in each term. Then we have 1 plus 1 plus 1 and so on. Obviously, this is a constant 1, and in this case, A is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. We all know that the sum of geometric sequence is normally represented by A over 1 minus R raised to the power n. On the similar manner, the sum of geometric series is equal to A over 1 minus R, where A is the first term of the sequence and R is the common ratio. But this is only for the case when R is less than 1. If mod of R is greater than or equal to 1, then the series is always divergent. So if we are able to confirm, or if we are able to discuss that if R given series is a geometric series, then we do not need to find out the partial sums of the series, and then we will apply the limit on that. We just need to check that if the value of common ratio, that is R, is less than 1 or greater than 1. If mod of R is less than 1, that is the absolute value of R is less than 1, then the series will be convergent and the sum will be equal to A over 1 minus R. If the absolute value of the common ratio is greater than 1 or equal to 1, then we will say that R series is divergent series. As we have discussed an example of geometric series with 1 plus 1 plus 1 and so on. So here you can see that the sum will be infinity and divergent. So it's also in this case R is equal to 1. So by definition it must be divergent. Here we have an example. We are given with a geometric series summation k varying from 0 to infinity 5 over 4 power k. So clearly A will be equal to 5 and R is equal to 1 by 4, which is less than 1. It means our series is convergent and its sum will be equal to A over 1 minus R. But for the second part, we have the series summation k varying from 1 to infinity 3 power 2 k 5 power 1 minus k. So we will try to simplify it in this form, that is 9 into 9 by 5 whole power k minus 1. We are just rearranging it in this form so that we can easily find out the common ratio, and obviously common ratio is going to be 9 by 5 in this case, which is greater than 1, so the series must be divergent. Here is an application of geometric series that we have to find out the rational number represented by the decimal 0.7847847784 and so on. So as we know that this one can be written as an infinite series in the form 0.784 plus 0.000784 plus 0.000000784 and so on. So here we are having an infinite series, and we will try to make this series to be a convergent geometric series so that we may be able to find out the sum in this case. So as we know that R is the common ratio, so common ratio means the quotient of the two consecutive terms must be equal to R. So R is equal to A2 by A1, or R is equal to A3 by A2, or R is equal to A4 by A3. So that by the dividing the two consecutive terms, we are able to find out the common ratio R. So here R will be equal to A2 by A1, so dividing A2 by A1, we get 0.00 0.001. So 0.001 is less than 1, so clearly it is convergent series with sum a over 1 minus r. So putting the values, we get 784 over 999. That is the given decimal is representing the fraction term or the rational number 784 divided by 999. Next we have harmonic series. Harmonic series is always divergent series, and it is represented as summation k varying from 1 to infinity 1 over k. It is not necessary that it is always 1 over k. That is, if we are adding the terms 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5 and so on, such series is named as harmonic series, and harmonic series are always divergent series. Here we have question number 4 from the exercise. We are given with the series summation k varying from 1 to infinity 2 by 3 whole power k plus 2. Clearly, we are having a power, so it means it is representing a geometric series over here. So here a1 will be equal to 8 by 27. Simply put, k is equal to 1 because it is starting from k is equal to 1. If it is starting from k is equal to 2, that is the first term corresponds to k is equal to 2. So then in that case, you have to put k will be 2. So right now, putting k is equal to 1, the first term is 8 by 27, and r will be equal to 2 by 3, which is less than 1, so it is a convergent series, and its sum will be equal to a over 1 minus r or a 1 over 1 minus r. So simplifying the sum, we get 8 by 9. Next we have question number 14. Again, it is a geometric series. Summation k varying from 1 to infinity 5 power 3 k 7 power 1 minus k. So here we may have a way, like in this previous example, that we try to simplify this in the general form to get an expression with power 1 minus k or power k, so that we may be able to find out r. Or you can solve this in the way that write down the first 2 to 3 terms of the series. That is, put k is equal to 1, then k is equal to 2, and then k is equal to 3, and so on. And we know that the common ratio is simply the division or the quotient of the two consecutive terms, so a2 by a1, that is 5 power 6 7 power minus 1 over 5 power 3 7 power 0, that is 1. So you can see this 3 will be subtracted, so we are left with 5 power 3 7 power minus 1, that is 125 by 7 is the common ratio r, and the first term is 125. So here is the common ratio r, that is greater than 1, so it means it is a divergent series, it cannot be a convergent one.